Maikaji, what would be your advice to students to channel their curiosities in the right direction and to kind of prepare them for an adulthood that is meaningful and safe?
You know, Mr. Bachchan, such a privilege to be talking to you. You know, I think we have to have open conversations with our children. You know, the teacher and the student relationship that we take great pride in at the Shriram School has to be one where the children are able to speak their mind. It's only then, when the channels are open, that we can actually have the three-way partnership where the parent comes in. Because all said and done, all of us have spoken about the same thing, that for the children, and parents have to be listeners somewhere. They really believe that the children don't know more than them, but that's not true. I mean, look at the pandemic now, when we all had to go online, when technology was such a challenge for so many homes. Who did the parents go to? Many parents spoke to me and said, we had to call upon our 12-year-old and say, okay, come teach me. So many people did that. So there's always a two-way learning, like I spoke about, to say that we have to allow our children to speak. We have to have positions in our student council, which have changed. You know, over the years, when you and I probably went to school, we had the four house captains, we had the student council president, and we had the head girl and the sports captain. Today, what we have introduced, and I think that's really helps, and I would encourage all the educators here to look at that body. We have a head of social initiatives. In fact, as I speak, the website for social initiatives, because it's Gandhi Jayanti today, has been launched today by the students for the students. Wow. We have a head of environmental initiatives who looks after Paryavaran. So a lot of children are encouraged to join the Paryavaran Club. And that's why the last one I met you, Bachchan Saab, was when we did the Swachh Bharat 5 years ago, when I had committed 5,000 hours by the Shriram School, and we did a very good job, I have to say. My children did a very good job. So open conversations, counselors, you know, for a lot of schools, we believe we know it all. Everyone doesn't know everything. And that's why we have a stream of the doctors, the COVID warriors today, you know, there's not one kind of doctor, so there's not one kind of educator. You have the counselors in your schools. You have to employ as many counselors. There has to be the clause of confidentiality where the children feel safe. In fact, we have told our children that what you discuss with your counselor in school, we don't need to know as heads of organizations. We don't need to know everything. That's your safe space between you and your counselor. You know, sound mentoring programs, those are the need of the day. Conversation time, circle time, things have changed. Schooling has changed. You know, knowledge can be gotten from anywhere. You open your net and the children have everything that they need. Probably they know more than the teacher today. I always say they know more than I do. But we need to teach them life skills. Nishiji spoke about them so beautifully. Who will teach them those skills? The schools and the parents together. So allow the children to make mistakes. Allow them to question. Provide the answers. Be good listeners. Schools have to be safe and kind spaces that children want to come to. They have to have a spring in their step when they come to school. And automatically through peer interaction, through teacher interaction, through alumni interaction, we invite our school alumni back for panel discussions to talk to our children on various topics. And you know, it's best that we grown-ups are not there in that hall at that point in time, because what they talk to somebody who graduated less than 2 years back is something different. They can ask all their questions without hesitation. So I think as teachers, as educators, we need to support our children to say it's okay to make a mistake. And that's what I would encourage, that open conversations, okay. You know, and the ability to be able to forgive and forget when children goof up. It's all right. We did it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Manika ji, and thank you, Richa ji, for joining us on this discussion, a very crucial discussion, and quite enjoyed it, frankly.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we've been... Through the day, Swasthya Mantra, you know, we've had these three pillars, health, hygiene and environment. And we're talking about health. You know, we've recently, just right now, we spoke about childhood, what it takes, you know, what is it like to actually take care of a child from birth till its adolescence? As kids grow, you know, there are other issues that need to be addressed. One of the most important among these is sex education. And it's really important that children and teenagers are aware and they make the right choices. Joining us now are Jakpreet Singh, headmaster of the Dune School, Atishi Marlena, she's a former advisor to Delhi Deputy CM on Education, Manika Sharma, director of the Shri Ram Schools, Nishi Misra, she's principal Sindhya Kanya Vidyalaya, and we have Richa Shukla, she's an educationalist. Let me come across to you, Ms. Sharma, what is the importance of adolescents' health education, sex education in schools, and what would you consider the key areas of focus for our adolescents?
Namaste. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, NDTV, for having me. Well, I come from the Shri Ram School, Delhi NCR, and we talk of genders in non-binary terms. We schools have a huge task at hand, and we need to encourage diversity and discussion. You know, sadly, many of us hesitate to do so. Probably we haven't grown up in times like these. So sexuality education for schools must be mandated. We must encourage individual thought, open discussions, debate, dissent, disagreements, because that's when we'll raise healthy adolescents. And need for gender inclusivity in our classrooms, I would say that's also very important. As an educator, I believe that knowledge is power, and knowledge is a two-way street. And we need to be able to have these conversations with our children today. That's where I come from.